right, today is Monday. We're back at it again, right? So yesterday was supposed to just be wraps for dinner, the tuna wraps. And I had those with some broccoli. It was good. It would have been healthy. Today would have been, or yesterday would have been a nutritional success if my wife didn't go ahead and make chocolate chip cookies. So when I came home from donating plasma, I was like sniffing around the house, like, you know, I was like, "You burn something?" No, we smell like something like burnt toast, right? Not burnt toast, but like toast was cooking. That smell of like almost burnt, but burnt bread, but not really burnt, but burnt, right? So I had, I don't know, like 3 to like 17 of those things. So that was a complete failure yesterday. Probably about 1,000 calories, 1,200 calories in just chocolate chip cookies. And I wasn't gonna eat dinner. But then one thing led to another and I had dinner too. Right? So but I didn't drink all weekend, so that's good. So that's you know, take your wins where you can get them, I guess. If I didn't eat those cookies, it would have been better. Today's a weigh-in, so we'll see how that this weekend affected me from Friday. Probably gonna have I don't even want to say a pound gain, because then I'll gain 3 and feel like crap. But donated plasma yesterday, went to the gym, like I talked about, to this morning. Just got out the gym like normal. Buys and tries. So I did my little set of curls, shoulder press, curls again, then, you know, with my double over the head, skull crusher, some shrugs. I added side dips, you know, where you hold the weight at your side and kind of dip down. I added that because I'm fat, so not really a big explanation there. I'm just fat and hate my body, so I added those to try and burn some of the love handles off. Then we did some abs, and it was kind of packed this morning for like 5 o'clock. Like every machine, like everyone was kind of there at 5. It was much more packed than normal. Maybe because it's a Monday, you know, people starting fresh on Mondays. So I did the machine curls, got a couple sets in there, maybe like 10 sets. Nothing crazy. They were good though. I just didn't do the, the tricep push down machine or whatever. So today we start OSHA, the phase 2. So hopefully that'll be good. Hopefully that class is happening, and hopefully it happens. Hopefully I get in. Should be a lot in. There shouldn't be any reason why not to. Excuse me. Yeah. So if I can get into those classes, that'll be good. That'll be this week. And then last night when we were going for a walk, one of the YouTubers my wife watches, that, you know, I side watch or whatever, because it's always on, so I hear everything. I know probably more about this YouTuber than their haters know, and they try to like religiously hate watch, which I don't quite understand why people hate watch someone. They're only watching you because they hate you and want to see you fail. But like, why not just admit you love watching that YouTuber? You know, because it makes you feel good for one reason or another. Like, whether someone motivates you to feel good, or they, you know, motivate you in the sense that they're failing, I don't know. It's hate watching. You know, you watch because you hate them. And then it's a whole bunch of like bullying. What kind of did irritate me though is that this YouTuber was doing it was supposed to be a live weigh-in, right? But the hate watchers, the more prevalent ones, the ones with more followers, let's say, were live or screen sharing that YouTuber's live stream. So more or less, to me, they're still like, already all they do is just kind of steal this YouTuber's full content and then put it on their channel and then have commentary. But like, their commentary is terrible, and all it is just watching the original YouTube video through someone else's channel, taking away the views or subscribers, which, I mean, it is what it is, but I don't think that the YouTuber stealing the original content, because to me it's theft, because they're not creating anything new. Like, you have your comments, but they're trash comments. It's a trash channel. And it's it's bullying, really, what it is. It is online bullying. I don't think that YouTube should pay them. That's just me. because they're not establishing themselves or creating anything new. They're just a hate channel. I mean, it's really all it is, a hate channel. And then you could see that their content from when they have, you know, their life or their weight loss goals or their updates or whatever, you know, let's say it has 1,000 views, which is still, you know, it's more than probably what I have at this point for whoever's listening. But when they steal the original YouTuber's content, they have 60,000, 70,000 views on that one video. Like, clearly no one cares about you. They're just going through a different outlet to hate watch or not provide monetary value to the original YouTuber. But I don't know. It irritated me. It always irritates me. Not that I'm a big, you know, fan or supporter of the YouTuber my wife watches. I mean, I got nothing against that person at all. Live your best life. Oh, they actually lost. So they did a live weigh and they lost 50 pounds, which is good because they've gained so much weight over the course of me side watching, if you will. So much weight, and then they lost. So they've been on a diet, and they always fail. So they've always failed and gained weight. But their latest weigh-in, I guess, over the course of the last 3 months, they lost 50 pounds. So that was, you know, that's good of them. You know, I'm happy for them. Not that it matters at all, but I mean, in the great cosmic scale of things, you know, putting them good vibes out there. But so they lost 50 pounds in 3 months. That was the whole point. And then I dislike hate channels. Or you could be a hate channel, but have some original content, you know? Like, there's hate channels of this YouTuber that, like, do cartoon parodies or voiceovers or whatever. And that, you know, it's funny. It's mean, but it's funny. But, like, the channels that just stream the original content and then, you know, don't even have good hate comments. Like, it'd be like for every 5 sentences the YouTuber talks, the hate watcher has a three-word comment. Like, dude, who cares? Like, you're, I don't know, it's irritating. And then what do I care, right? Who cares? What do I care? It has nothing to do with me. It's just my thoughts and my opinions, and I'm entitled to them just like you are. But yeah, I dislike hate watchers, hate channels. That's all I got, I think. I don't know. We ate dinner. It was a lot of dinner. I cleaned my couch. Not that anyone cares, but that was a monumentous feat to take all the cushions and stuffing out and wash them. It smells good. It looks like a brand new couch now. So, I mean, did that. And, you know, but there's no relevance to anyone. You don't care. Nobody cares. I barely care. So that's today. Hopefully this week we do good. You know, I'm gonna see about running. If this OSHA class is like the last OSHA class and I get 2-hour breaks, you know, I get to go run for lunch. So I'll make sure that I go run. Of course, I have my clothes with me, so it'll be what it'll be. Until tomorrow.